find the winner of the last as Mojo Rhythm goes in. Off racing. Never Sober seemed to anticipate the start, landed clearly in front. Now going up on the outside, No Change, gathering speed, and No Dice will be handy. Over on the inside, soon after the start, ahead of Vast Art, Paddy's Lad further back on the rail, Vitalised Mojo Rhythm. My Mate settling in the back of the field, and last of all is Savinik. Out by the 1,000 metres they head, and it's Never Sober. In control, leads the way in the last over No Change. They're a length and a half to the good of No Dice, pushing up for Pike, down on the inside of Vast Art. Then Paddy's Lad, Vitalised is next on the rail, ahead of the favourite Mojo Rhythm, then My Mate Savinik at the tail end of the field. They come along past the 700, Never Sober quickening up the tempo, three quarters over No Change, two lengths to Vast Art, No Dice on the rails, a length and a half behind them to Vitalise, Paddy's Lad being followed over on the outside by Mojo Rhythm, now being hoisted to the outside to come after them, Savinik further back and My Mate relegated to last, their homeward bound, Never Sober joined by No Change. No Change on the outside hits the front, Vast Art in pursuit, No Dice, Mojo Rhythm at the 200, No Change on the outside, draws a half a length, Vast Art back behind them, then No Dice trying to pick its way through a narrow opening, Vast Art, No Change, No Change, Vast Art, No Change, they went to it, Vast Art got there narrowly from No Change, No Dice, Vitalised Savinik from well off them, charging to the line from Never Sober, Mojo Rhythm just a little bit flat on the 7 day spin around, only beat a couple home in including Paddy's Lad, who's second last, and at the tail end of the field is My Mate. Vast Art takes out the final event here at Ascot for the season. Number 10, the Flying Artie, three-year-old for Darren McAuliffe, with Clint Johnston Porter in the saddle. Vast Art gets home by a long head from No Change and No Dice. No Cigar. It's Vast Art that wins the last here on the card for Impressive Racing and their partners in Madams Perkins and Shepherd Green Walker, Artemis and Clark Gibson, Griffiths, Lucive, McCleary, Meckenstock, Moneywood, Putland, Blackwell, Combendown and Pratt, and certainly did have excuses last time out in a mile race at Pinjarra, having won there previous in a Class 3, and has delivered down in the weights onto the limit this afternoon to win by that slender margin. Home in 34.35. Defeating the very consistent No Change by Reward for Effort from Roll On Rose, Sean and Jake Casey, Brandon Louis, and third being No Dice by Bradbury's Luck from Carter Ford, Sarah Evans teaming up with Willie Pike in the Crown Perth Handicap. Mojo Rhythm there, they backed, it just didn't quite let down, maybe lacked a little bit of that dash after the win here last weekend and couldn't match it with them over the final stages. Savinik, though, hit the line hard right on their heels with Vitalise. Let's go down now into the enclosure. Darren McAuliffe is there, and with him is Brittany Taylor.
He's on strapping duty, so I'll walk with him. D-Mac, congratulations. Tell us about the performance today, what you thought of Vast Art.
He worked good during the week, and Emma was very confident he'd run well. So, yeah, it's made the long day rewarding, I guess. So, yeah.
You were in the first and last. I have to get a word on Massamoon, because that was some sort of debut after hanging terribly around the corner.
Yeah, I don't know what happened there. He's been he's an absolute gentleman and very, very bomb-proof, but obviously not today. So, who knows?
With this horse, a three-year-old, what's the plan going forward?
Oh, who knows? He's just a little bit of a unknown commodity. He goes very, very good, and he's big and strong, but he does a lot of stuff wrong. So we'll just sort of try and guide him as best we can.
Go get him. Well done.
Thank you.
There is Darren McAuliffe, who will go and grab Vast Art. Very happy connections here, including our photographer on course, Sharon Walker, who is in the ownership, and she's going to run in and get a photo. Simon Merritt's jumped in. She's still got a camera in hand so that she can get in the winner's photo as part of the ownership, which is just great to see. Her and her husband, Mike, some of the loved characters on any racetrack in WA.
I spoke to Simon after the previous race when there was a trophy presentation, and he said, no, that's it for me, I'm heading home. And Sharon's obviously pulled him into line and said, I think my horse can win the last, you better stay around.
And that is exactly what the boss has done, as he's told, to make sure that he's here so that Sharon can get a photo here with Vast Art in the last of the day, the last here at Ascot. Can I press you for a highlight from the Ascot season, Scott? It's been a really long season when you think back to opening day, and we've seen some incredible performances along the way. What's been a moment that stands out?
Oh, the entire racing community getting around Colin Webster when Tricks of the Trade won the Railway. That's clearly a highlight for me, Britt. I love the way that no matter what the result was, whether you were aboard Tricks of the Trade or whether you'd backed a horse that got beaten or trained or owned, even the jockeys were coming out. Geordie Turner in tears for his dad coming back into the mountain yard. So it was really emotional scenes and something that will stay with me for a long time, the way that everyone just wrapped their hands and their love around Mr. Webb.
Yeah, it was incredible, even for weeks to come. I think it was very surreal for Mr. Webb because the well wishes just did not stop for him, and it was very, very special, that win of Tricks of the Trade in the Railway, the Pinnacle Series, obviously so wonderful. And then the first run of the Quokka, that was just something else to be here at Ascot for. But as for the final time, the final winner of this Ascot season, here's Clint Johnson Porter.
Yes, final winner of the Ascot season goes to CJP. Clint, a nice pickup ride this.
Yeah, it was a very good pickup ride. Looked at its form and it looked like a very nice horse. He did everything I expected him to.
Travelled into the race really nicely from a good spot as well.
Yeah, I loved, drawing a gate was key today. Just put me in a good spot, didn't have to do anything about it. And it was just free running into the straight.
Some pretty handy three-year-old races coming up, Raconteur Stakes, Belmont Guineas and the like. Does he seem like a three-year-old that can continue on those winning ways?
Yeah, definitely. I think he's going to get a bit more of a trip. And he's dumb and he's probably just working it out a bit. So I think with a bit more race experience, he's going to be a top little horse.
Sharon Walker's in the ownership of this one, so you might get a free Western Race Picks photo or two out of this. Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
There is Clint Johnson Porter, combined with Darren McAuliffe, and Vast Art wins the final race of the day, the Crown Perth Handicap. Thanks for your company today on Sky Thoroughbred Central, and indeed throughout this Ascot season as well. Cannot wait to bring you the coverage from Belmont.